Good evening and welcome to the Eco of India's interview program. We are on air right now, and this is the Eco of India's first interview show, you know, the first episode of interview show, which we are starting on our Facebook page. So today I'm joined by Ashish Kumar from Mirik. Ashish has qualified UPSC Civil Services. His All India rank is 53, and it's pleasure to have you, Ashish, here. So welcome to the show. And
thank you so much.
Good evening, Mirik. Good evening, Darjeeling. Anyone who's watching us from Mirik, from Karshong, this is your show, because Ashish is from Darjeeling. So it's pleasure having you, Ashish, here on the show. We'll get it straight into a few questions for which I think people will be interested in, the questions for which people will be looking forward to, must be seeking answers. If it's Ashish Kumar and he's from Mirik, so why Ashish is on the Eco of India's page? That's a big question. So Mirik, Darjeeling, welcome, and pleasure to have you here, to host you here, Ashish. First thing, tell us something about yourself, and then we get into this UPSC Civil Services examination journey.
So I've been born and brought up in the Darjeeling district. So I was born in Karshong, and I did my schooling from Guthals Memorial School in Karshong. And so for my class 11 and 12, I moved to Army Public School, Sukna, so which is also in Darjeeling district itself. And beyond that, so I wanted to become a banker. So that is why I moved to Delhi University, where I graduated in economics. So however, over time, so I developed a liking towards the civil services, and accordingly I prepared and could achieve success in my second attempt. Sir.
All right, so this was your second attempt that okay, but it's great. I mean, you made it in the second at least, or to say it that way, that it's an achievement, of course. Another point I have in mind, Ashish, is because there will be people who will be watching you later, this show they will be watching, and people aspire to become, a civil servant, a bureaucrat. But before I move on to that, let me ask you a question that were you always planning to be a bureaucrat, or was it accidental? Or because you said you studied economics, so the natural course would have been, to take, as you said, also a banker's job, do an MBA, go for a corporate job. What brought you into UPSC?
So it was a mix of both accident as well as planning. So initially I did want to become a banker, and that is why I took economics. So however, when I moved to Delhi, so I got the chance to interact with some people, who had already cleared the civil services. And, in my talks with them, I got to know that, this service provides the best opportunity, to make grassroots level interventions and improve the lives of people in our country. And this motivated me, that I should pursue a career on the civil services and make my contribution towards nation building.
All right, so another important question that comes in is, it's something very tough, to get through UPSC perhaps, or do you think it's easy?
So I wouldn't say it is tough. However, so it would also be injustice to call it easy. So it is one of the most competitive exams in India. So however, with proper hard work, and most importantly, a proper strategy. So if one knows exactly what is studying, why am I studying this book? Why am I writing this question? If all that is clear, so I think with hard work as well as smart work, so success in this exam is very much possible.
All right. So hard work as well as smart work. I mean, those are two keywords which I'm picking from your interview. Yeah. Now tell us something about, how you went about preparing. Because I also want to understand, because you moved from perhaps from Karshong or Mirik to Delhi, and you prepared in Delhi?
Yes, sir. So for the initial 1.5 year, I was in Delhi. And for the past 9 or 10 months, I've been preparing from Mirik itself.
Okay. So tell us something about, how one should go about preparing for this exam.
So firstly, one must have a very clear idea of exactly how one is going to prepare, what books are to be referred, and one should have a rough timeline. Like I had a timeline that I will give two and a half years to this exam, and if I am not able, I'll look for other option as well. So for this, what I did was, one needs to first watch a lot of topper videos. So to get a basic idea of exactly, you know, what books they referred to, or what are the common mistakes they made, or what are the common things they did right. So accordingly, one needs to make the strategy. Then secondly, so it is also important to look at the previous year questions, so be it of the prelims or the mains, so one exactly knows what the UPSC expects from a candidate who wants to join the civil services. So, and thirdly, and most importantly, I think, sir, for this exam, what is required is, sir, the hard work as well as introspection. So one needs to daily self-assess. So if am I writing a question wrong? What am I doing right here? So this needs to be done every day, so in order to improve every day, and accordingly, so one will be able to clear this examination.
Right. So that's important. You mentioned that, you know, hard work and smart work. So what are these two? You know, how do you define work as hard, and how do you define work as smart? Any distinction which you have, because it will help others to understand it better.
Yes, sir. So firstly, sir, hard work is an essential. So one has to do hard work. So however, there are thousands and lakhs of people appearing this exam, and so a lot of them are working hard. So simply hard work isn't enough to clear this exam. So one also needs smart work. And by smart work, what I mean, sir, for example, if we take the examples of the preliminary examination. So what candidates focus is on is they simply focus on gathering more and more knowledge. So which has no end, and one will not be able to remember all the information. So rather than only focusing on knowledge, one needs to focus on the elimination techniques. You know, how do I eliminate options that I do not know and get to the answer. So and for the mains, what the smart work I did was that UPSC has a very defined syllabus. It has defined even sub points of the syllabus. So if I may give an example, certain topics of the syllabus are education, health, or the role of civil services. So I made some short notes based on the internet research and all of these topics. So I had basic fodder to write answers upon. So this way I could ensure that my hard work was channeled, and so it became smart work, and accordingly helped me clear this exam.
Okay, one more thing. Like it's of course your interview, but I am getting more interested in UPSC exams, because perhaps people will be watching. Yes. And trying to understand, you know, taking an inspiration while watching your interview. So I'm asking you more questions on UPSC, and I'll come back to Mirik to ask you a few more questions on your life and how you know, have grown up in Kanchipuram and Darjeeling. One thing which I'm asking for the aspirants is, you know, how do you maintain a balance? Because see, today you have most of, or I think the, you know, a major chunk of study material available online. Is there a ratio? Is there some kind of formula one should maintain while studying, you know, hard copy, you know, the books and the online? How, because you say you also talk about smart, you know, work. So you said that you know, you can eliminate or learn to eliminate answers, you know, when attempting a certain question. So how should one choose between how much time to give on internet, how much time to give on books, or if they are also attached to some kind of, and do you think it's actually important to be a part of some kind of training institute to qualify?
So if one has, firstly, say one has the right guidance, so one does not need to be part of any training institute to qualify this exam. And so secondly, so regarding the balance between online and offline, I believe it would depend upon candidate to candidate. So certain basic books which are there, so they have to be offline. So because you will get proper consolidated and topic by topic material on them. So for them, one needs to refer to offline sources. So however, there are certain topics in the syllabus which are not covered in the standard books. So for this one, refers to online sources. And so one more thing I would say is that one really needs to be careful while using online resources, because it is very easy to start watching educational video on YouTube and then begin watching movie trailers and other kind of videos. So one needs to have that discipline that I will use internet only for the topics not there in the standard books.
All right. Yeah, that's important. I think that's a major, because we always get tempted that, you know, once you go online, you may go into the social media, you may start playing games. Yes. And there's a lot of stuff. If you may just, I don't know if, but I think you should be knowing that is, can you recall one or two tough questions that you faced in the exams?
So in the mains or in the interview?
I think you can share, from the both, if whatever you want to share on this.
Right. So in the mains, what I found tough was the essay papers. And essays, especially in the, there are like two essays one has to write. And the first essay that comes, nowadays we are getting more and more philosophical essays. So to basically sort of put the concrete points into the abstract format was a bit difficult. For example, so there was this essay regarding that courage to accept and willingness to move forward is the key to success. And one had to write 12 pages on this. So this was challenging, and I had practiced writing such essays before the mains exam also. So, and regarding the interview, so it was mostly on my application form and the things that I have done throughout my life. However, so there were some tough questions. And one tough question that I recall was that sir told me that, give me a 1 minute speech on why civil services is the worst job. So I think I handled that also
Oh, that's like
decently
that
well.
was a tricky question, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is like, I think we talked enough about the exams, the preparation. Now tell us something about Mirik, about Karshyung, about Darjeeling. I mean, a lot of people are watching from Darjeeling. Perhaps they will watch it later. So tell us something about Darjeeling.
So Darjeeling, has been my hometown, and I have stayed here almost for the major part of my life. So all my friends or be it my schoolings so from Guthals or from Army Public Schools, and whatever so I am today, so be it in academic wise or personality wise or even culture wise, I am very attached to this place, and I am very thankful to the people of the hills, who have always been very supportive, and so one of the most welcoming people one can find, sir.
Right, great. Ashish, thank you so much for joining us for this interview at the Eco of India's social platform. And we wish you best of luck for your future.
Thank you, sir.
Viewers, thanks for watching the interview, the first in our series. And we hope to get you more interviews in this program later. Take care. Goodbye.